Okay, well, as Fabian already said, my name is José Maria Ross. I work for Perstorp Feed and Food as an expert in gut health products. The aim of this webinar is to give an introduction and an outlook about how to prevent enteropathogens to grow along the digestive tract. In order to do so, I have split the webinar in four parts. The first part will be talking about the role of the short-chain fatty acids in the feed industry. Later on, we will talk about butyric acid and their multiple effects towards gut health, and then tributyrin as the most effective way to deliver butyric acid to the intestine, together with proven results about this. Okay, well, then short-chain fatty acids are used in the feed industry since the 1960s. The first application reason was mold control. But since then, the reason for them to be used has been increased, so was their geographical expansion. According to FEFANA, which is the European Association for Ingredients and Additives, the global market is worth 1 billion euro nowadays, and it's been growing at a yearly pace of 4.5% in the last 7 years, meaning three times as much as the global feed production worldwide. The region where their use is more common is in Europe, maybe or very likely because the stricter regulations in terms of food and feed safety, salmonella control, or antibiotic use reduction. But elsewhere in the world, there are well-known products, quite popular and also increasing very nicely in terms of market share. The first reason for using short-chain fatty acids was, and they still be, feed preservation. They have the ability to control or to kill molds and bacteria, and because of that, by using them, we can prevent spoilage by molds or mycotoxin forming, so as a reduction of enterobacteria counts in the feed, reducing the number of enteros entering into the gastrointestinal tract of the animal. Because of that, they are first choice products for salmonella control plants in feed. The chart on the right is showing one of the abundant trials showing results to that regard. I've chosen this one, which is a trial run in the Technical Center for Animal Nutrition in France, and it was about a sample with a really high contamination of enterobacteria, and that was treated with four different acid-based products. And as an average, all of them managed to decrease the percentage of enterobacteria by 100 times as an average. The next good reason was acidification. Oral acidification is a way to support the chloridric acid production in the proventriculus in the birds. This is a good way to boost the predigestion in the stomach because it's adding more acid into the proventriculus and also increase the feed retention time in the stomach. That enables a better predigestion and thus a better absorption of nutrients later on. In the slide, in the graph on the right, you can see how effective formic acid can be by reducing pH in either in feed or in the stomach of the animals. Last main target by using short-chain fatty acids has been the enterobacteria control, but this time inside the gastrointestinal tract. Looking at the charts on the top on the right, the top one is about a sample, feed sample contaminated with Salmonella enteritidis, and this feed sample was either treated or untreated with short-chain fatty acids. What we find out is in 1 hour the feed treated with short-chain fatty acids were managed to decrease by more than 50% the number of salmonella in the crop. It happens pretty much the same about if we control E. coli in duodenum, and there you can see how control and treated or formic acid treated feeds manage to get very different figures in terms of E. coli entering into the intestine. That means that short-chain fatty acids helps very much to decrease the microbial pressure inside the intestine. Well, but those is are results. Results are produced in the first part of the digestive tract, from the feet until the duodenum, not any further. The thing is that the focus has to be put mostly on the intestine, for a number of reasons. An increasing pressure for improving the performance results. The control and the control of the antibiotics use, either as growth promoter or treatments, are two good reasons, but are not the only one. Enteropathogens can find in the intestine the optimal environment for them to grow. They have substrate, nutritional substrate, temperature, moisture, optimal pH, but also a host that is struggling to cope with the performance demand and the stressful conditions in the farm. That's why a good way to prevent problems is to boost or enhance the natural mechanism for defense of the animals. And it's not a matter that's of surprise that also short-chain fatty acids can play an active role in that regard. Acetic, propionic, or butyric are short-chain fatty acids that are commonly naturally occurring in the intestine as a result of the fermentation of dietary fiber or undigestible saccharides by microbiota. And it's also well known that they are excellent energy source for colonocytes and enterocytes. But besides this, butyric acid has been proven by research to have outstanding traits with regard to gut health. This image is based on a paper published by the INRA, French Institute for Animal Nutrition, trying to summarize the proven by research effects of the butyric acid at the intestine level. And there you can see how not only are talking about effect over the enterocytes, I mean energy for colonocytes or enterocyte proliferation and specialization, but also effects on the microbiota by controlling the growth of enteropathogens and modulating the good microflora. There are some points also specifically addressed to the mechanism for defense of the animal, like mucus formation by stimulating the globet cells activity, control on the inflammation, or even effect of repair on the lesions in the tissues. Besides that, it's also known that they have a positive effect over the nutrient absorption, and this is because the increasing of the surface absorption surface in the intestine, and also because it has been associated to increase the amount of digestible enzymes in the lumen of the intestine. Okay, then, being so, the challenge is how can we allocate the more efficient way butyric acid into the intestine? Butyric acid is a small molecule, really volatile and nasty smelling, that will be absorbed by any mucosa that he can get in touch with. For these reasons, it cannot be used as such, and then we need to protect them in order to make it more durable. Until some years, the best solution found has been coated butyric acid source. Coated butyric acid is about sodium or calcium butyrate covered by a matrix, fat matrix, that enables him to go through all the feed processing process and the gastric pH in the stomach to reach the intestine in without any losses. When the coated is well done, is a very good method to deliver product there, but it has two relevant drawbacks, to my opinion. The first one is the fat matrix. It takes a lot of space into the product. It's about 70%, so that leaves little effective room for the active ingredient, which is butyric acid. This way, we can only deliver 25% as maximum butyric acid in the intestine. The other problem is a good coating is an expensive production system, so it's not that cost effective. Since a few years, triglycerol esters of butyric acid are available in the market. They are commonly known as tributyrins. They are about glycerol, which is the backbone for three molecules of butyric acid that get attached to them by ester bonds. These ester bonds are very strong and can resist all the production stages in the feed, any type of production process, as well as the gastric pH, so they can reach the intestine with no losses on the way. Because of that, they don't need any matrix or coating, and being so, they can deliver in the intestine up to 85% butyric acid as liquid product. Dry products can reach 55, which is more than double than the coated forms. Besides that, it's to remark that it has no other issues and it's friendly use. We've got a number of results with Profors SR, which is the tributyrin by Perstorp. The first one I'm going to show you is about a trial run in United Kingdom in ADAS Research Centre, and there's a competitive trial. It was about three groups, one control group, broiler groups, the first one, the control one. The next group was treated with Profors SR at 0.5 or 250 kilos in the first and the second stage, 250 grams per kilo per ton, sorry, and coated butyrate, which was dosed exactly the double of this dosing. The reason for this is the target was to place in the intestine the same amount of butyric acid. The results are pretty clear, meaning that both groups treated with butyric acid in either way outperformed the control group, despite the control group is already delivering excellent results. And when we compare the two groups treated, the results are exactly the same. That means that we can support the message that Profors SR is as double as effective as coated sodium butyrate. We have run also a number of trials. You can see the chart on the right about performance results in front of control groups with not any treatment. And there, what you can see is that the average daily gain, the average of all, is about 3.4% improvement, whereas for the feed conversion is 3.9. It's a matter of common sense, the understanding that the lower improvement is usually for farms with less challenge. That means experimental farms. The reason for these improvements can be found here, at least part of the reasons. The first one, the chart on the left, is about the belly length in the intestine of birds receiving or not receiving Profors SR. In red, you can see the ones with Profors SR. There's a problem in the slide. The text is not correct, but the two first, the yellow and red, corresponding to duodenum, the next two about jejunum, and the last two to ileum. And you can see that comparing with the correspondent part of the digestive intestine, in the three parts, we managed to get significant improvements. This trial was done in the Shandong University of China, and it was introduced in the European Symposium for Poultry Nutrition. The chart on the right is about bacteria counts, and we can see there how birds receiving Profors SR has much lower counts on Clostridium, E. coli, and Salmonella. The three of them are decreased in a significant manner, while Lactobacilli is increasing also in a significant manner, giving once again a proof that butyric acid can have an effective role controlling the pathogens in the intestine and improving the balance towards the gut flora. The last trial I'm going to show you is about a challenge with necrotic enteritis. This one run in the United States by the Poultry Research Group in Georgia, in Atlanta. And the setup of the trial was as follows. There were about four groups of broilers. One was kept as negative control, and the other three were challenged with necrotic enteritis model, meaning that Clostridium perfringens was inoculated orally during 4 days in a row for the three groups. The positive control received no treatment, What is called Proforzesar group received challenge and treatment with Proforzesar, again at 500 grams and 250 grams. And the last one was treated with bacitracin at 50 grams during the whole reading period. You see four th three groups of bars. The first is corresponding to the average daily gain at day 21, at 30, and the second at 35th, and then at 42, the last one. If we go to the last one, what we can see is that numerically, Proforzesar managed to improve even the negative control, but from a statistical point of view, negative control and Proforzesar or bacitracin gets pretty much the same result. The conclusion, looking at the figures in that way, is that Proforzesar can at least equal the effect of a growth promoter such as bacitracin in the case of necrotic enteritis challenge. Results about feed conversion went in that line as well. Well, to sum up in a nutshell, hope we have managed to put some light on the way short-chain fatty acids are working and why they are so commonly used. Why butyric acid is the preferred option in terms of gut health for the animals, and the three butyrins as the most reliable way to supply butyric acid into the animal. Thank you for joining.
Thank you, Jose. Thank you very much. I just wondered, organic acids have a track record in feed preservation, but do you see a move into water treatment usage as well, and to which extent?
Well, in fact, it is already a common practice, the use of organic acid in drinking water. It's another way to apply it. At the end, it's about the same product, but the same concept, but in a different way. The feed can provide a regular and consistent treatment and prevention. The treatment in water is about spotter treating specific critical phases or stages. It has the good thing about the flexibility and the readiness for use. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But they can go along together.
Yeah,
in
yeah.
fact, they are.
And what is the role of organic acids in a post-antibiotic era? And you show some results about comparison with bacitracin and organic acids, but where is it most effective then?
Okay, well, I think what we have is clear to all of us is that there's no full replacement for antibiotics. This is clear. What we can do on organic with organic acids is to improve gut health, to create conditions for antibiotics be lesser needed. I remember of a nutritionist handling a very important integration telling me after some trials with Proforzesar that the feed additives Proforzesar cannot do all the job. It's a matter of biosecurity, but when it comes to biosecurity, then organic acids can play a great role.
Okay, well, thank you. I heard some great takeaways from this. Thank you
Okay.
for your clear presentation.
Thank you.